Once upon a time there was a boy named Bill. One morning he went to seek his fortune. He hadn't gone very far before he met a donkey, giraffe, and antelope.
Where are you going, Jack?
I am going to seek my fortune.
May we go with you?
Yes, the more the merrier.
They went a little further and they met a raccoon, Piggy, and Teddy.
Where are you going, Bill?
I am going to seek my fortune.
May we go with you?
Yes, the more the merrier.
Well, they went on till it was about dark, and they began to think of some place where they could spend the night. Then they saw a house.
Keep still, let me look through the window.
We want to go with you, Bill.
No, wait here.
Then Bill went to see through the window, and he saw some robbers counting over their money.
We robbed good, hey. I want my share of the money.
Oh, I must go and tell the others what I saw.
Then Bill went back and told them what he saw.
I have an idea. We will make all the noise we can.
Good plan.
So when they were all ready, Jack gave the word, and the cat mewed, and the dog barked, and the donkey brayed, and the piggy grunt, and the raccoon growls, and altogether they made such a dreadful noise that it frightened the robbers all away.
Great job. Now let's go and take possession of the house.
Bill was afraid the robbers would come back in the night, and so when it came time to go to bed he said,
Cat, you will get in the rocking chair, and you dog get under the table. As to Piggy, go upstairs, and you Bull go to the cellar, and finally, you, Raccoon, go up onto the roof, and I will go to bed.
When the robbers saw it was all dark, they sent one man back to the house to look after their money. Then he came back very frightened and said,
I went back to the house, went in and tried to sit down in the rocking chair, and there was an old woman knitting, and she stuck her knitting needles into me.
But that was the cat.
Then I went to the table to look after the money, and there was a shoemaker under the table, and he stuck his awl into me.
But that was the dog.
I started to go upstairs, and there was a man up there threshing, and he knocked me down with his flail.
But that was the donkey.
I started to go down cellar, and there was a man down there chopping wood, and he knocked me up with his axe.
But that was the giraffe.
But I shouldn't have minded all that if it hadn't been for that little fellow on top of the house, who kept a-hollering, chuck him up to me, E. Chuck him up to me, E.
But that was the raccoon.
What? Let's get out of town.
The end.